Hello, my name is Sixbert Rutajinara. I came to United Kingdom in 1994 as an asylum seeker from Tanzania. Today I will be going to interview Barros Barwani, a refugee from Congo DRC. So now let's hear from Barros himself. Please, could you introduce yourself?
My name is Barros Barwani. I came from Congo. Before arriving in the UK, I was a refugee in a refugee camp in Tanzania. I lived there for about 10 years in that refugee camp before being resettled in the UK.
When and why did you leave Congo?
I left Congo in 1996 because of the war that broke up. The rebel wanted to overthrow the government, and that led to conflict. Everything was in a disorder. We couldn't go to school as children, and there was no peace at all. So we had to flee from Congo to Tanzania.
What was the situation in Congo, and how did you feel separated from your mom, dad, sisters, and brothers?
The situation in Congo was very, very bad. Because of the war, we were separated. My dad fled to a different country in Uganda, and me, my mother, my two sisters, and my uncles, we fled to Tanzania. So we assumed that my dad died because we didn't know where he went, and he also assumed same thing, that we dead in the war because we are not in contact.
What was like when you used to live in the refugee camp, and any idea how many people are in the camps?
The refugee camp life was very difficult because we were about 500,000 of refugees in that refugee camp, and life was very, very difficult, especially with the food. There was not enough provision, and also for clothing, we couldn't have enough to clothe ourselves. But the refugee, the UNHCR, the agency that supports refugees worldwide, was helping us.
What are the types of minerals from Eastern Congo?
Congo are very rich. Is very rich in natural resources. For example, there's gold, diamonds, and the cobalt.
Who is fighting who, and who is benefiting from it?
The currently government is fighting against the rebel that want to take over the government, and that led to many conflicts, which the population is the one who suffered from it.
Do you think the media here are reporting in a neutral and factual manner of the predicaments of the people in those regions?
The media here doesn't report everything that's going on over there, and people over here, they don't know what basically is going on. I think the media should look into that and try to tell the people what is going on in Congo.
How did the war impact your family?
The war separated my family. Because of that, my dad now lives in the US, and we live over here in the United Kingdom. My aunties and my other uncles, some of them, they live in Australia, Norway, South Africa. So my family has been scattered all over the world because of the war.
How has your life been transformed from Congo to UK?
There has been a lot of changes in my life, because in the UK I have the opportunity to go to school, where in Congo I didn't have that opportunity because of the war. In the UK I can do anything that I want, even continue for my education.
What do you miss in Congo?
In Congo, I miss the food. The food is very tasty. It tastes very nicely. And also in Congo is very warm, it's a warm country, where here in the UK is very cold, so I miss the warm in Congo.
What did you study?
I studied in Manchester College and I did mechanic because I can speak many languages, that French, Swahili, English, and Lingala. So I also studied to be as an interpreter or a translator.
Which region are you?
I am one of the 250,000 Jehovah's Witnesses in the UK.
Which football team do you support?
Well, I am a United fan, so I am a big fan of Manchester United. And so far we are doing well. We are doing well. We beat Liverpool recently. So yeah, even Mourinho, the manager, is doing well at the moment.
What do you do for a living?
I work as a barber, so I cut people's hair. I do mainly men's hair. Most of my customers are white people or European people, and I am good at doing European hair than doing African's hair.
Which challenges did you face when arrived in the UK?
There was a lot of challenges when I arrived. The biggest was the language, to break the language barrier. Because when I arrived in the UK, I couldn't speak any English at all. And I have to go to Manchester College to learn English for 2 years. Then I did the mechanic course.
What can you tell us about Gateway Protection Program?
Yeah, Gateway Protection Program is a program that is run by the UK government. Is to bring 750 refugees each year to settle them in the UK. And those refugees are those who are vulnerable in their country. So the UK government is doing that to help refugees, and we thank them for that program. Because of that, I am here. Thank you very much for that.
What is the political situation in Congo?
So far, the situation is not good, but it's a bit better compared to how it used to be. So at the moment, there are still some rebels, and the government army is fighting against those rebels.
What do you do in a leisure time?
In a leisure time, I like playing my guitar. Dumbulu, 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 dumbulu. Yeah, that is one of my favorite songs. We play it in Congolese parties, and it's a very nice song that is very popular in Congo.
Thank you very much, Mr. Barros.
Yeah, thank you. I'd also like to thank the UK government that running the Gateway Protection Program, and also to thank the Tanzania government that welcomed me in their country because I was a refugee over there. And even the UK government, I thank them a lot.
Thank you.
Thank you.